Hello students, I am Bishwajit Nath. Welcome to my YouTube channel Best Physics Guide by Bishwajit Nath. Today I am going to discuss about the equation of motion of a particle moving along a straight line. Let the initial position of a particle at the point P, and for coordinate of the point P is x1, y1 and z1. And the position vector of the point P is r1. After time t, it moves to the point Q. The position vector of Q is r2 and its coordinate is x2, y2 and z2. Therefore, the displacement of the particle is r vector. Okay. Now, we can write that r vector is equal to r2 minus r1. This is the displacement of the particle. That is, r is equal to x2 minus x1 I cap plus y2 minus y1 j cap plus z2 minus z1 k cap. This is the displacement of the r is the displacement of the particle from P to Q. That is, the displacement of the particle is the shortest distance between the initial and final position of that particle. Therefore, the average velocity of the particle is v average is equal to r vector divided by time t, that is time taken t. This gives average vector is equal to x2 minus x1 I cap plus y2 minus y1 j cap plus z2 minus z1 k cap whole divided by t. This is the average vector of the particle. V is the average velocity of the particle. That is, average velocity of the particle is equal to displacement vector r divided by time taken t. Now, the instantaneous velocity of the particle, that is velocity of the particle at any moment, is given by v vector is equal to dr dt, that is derivative of r vector, displacement vector with respect to time dt. This gives v is equal to dx dt I cap plus dy dt j cap plus dz dt k cap. To find out the velocity at a moment, then after differentiating the r vector with respect to t, then we can put the value of time t. Therefore, we can easily find out the velocity of that particle at that particular moment. Let the equation of the displacement of a particle is t I cap plus 2 t square j cap plus t cube k cap meter. Therefore, instantaneous velocity of the particle v is equal to dr dt is equal to I cap plus 4 t j cap minus 3 t square k cap. Therefore, velocity of the particle at t is equal to 1 second is v at t is equal to 1 second is equal to dr dt at t is equal to 1 second. Now, after differentiating differentiating r vector with respect to t, we can put the value of t is equal to 1 second in this equation. This gives instantaneous velocity of the particle at t is equal to 1 second is I cap plus j cap minus 3 k cap meter per second. Therefore, the displacement of the particle from the time t1 to t2, we have integration of r1 to r2 dr, integration of r1 to r2 dr is equal to integration of t1 to t2 v dt. Since v is equal to dr dt, therefore, integrating both sides, we can find the displacement of the particle from time t1 to t2. Therefore, displacement of the particle, that is r2 minus r1. Here r1 is the initial position of the particle and r2 is the final position of the particle. This gives integration of t1 to t2. Integration of t1 to t2, t1 is the initial time and t2 is the final time, is equal to integration of v with respect to time t. This gives the displacement of the particle. Now you know that acceleration of the particle can be defined as the rate of change of velocity of that particle. Therefore, the average acceleration of the particle is A average is equal to V2 minus V1, that is final velocity minus initial velocity, V2 minus V1 by time taken t, that is final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time taken. This is the average acceleration of the particle. But the instantaneous acceleration of that particle, A, is derivative of V with respect to time. After differentiating V with respect to time, we can put the time in this equation or in the defined derivative. Then we can find the velocity acceleration of the particle at that moment, acceleration of the particle at that moment. That is instantaneous acceleration of the particle, A is equal to degree. Therefore, change of velocity of the particle during time t1 to t2 is integration v1 to v2 dv is equal to integration t1 to t2 a dt. This gives v2 minus v1, this is the change of the velocity of the particle, is equal to integration t1 to t2 a dt. Let a particle moves with a constant acceleration a. Its initial velocity is v1. After time t, its velocity becomes v2. Therefore, change in velocity of the particle v2 minus v1 is equal to integration of a with respect to dt from time 0 to t. Since a is constant, that's why the integration, only integration of dt gives t. Therefore, v2 minus v1 is equal to a t. This gives v2 is equal to v1 plus a t. This is the equation of velocity of a particle with moving with a constant acceleration a, where v1 is the initial velocity of the particle and t is the time taken. We know the instantaneous velocity of the particle is v is equal to dr dt. Therefore, integration of r1 to r2 dr is equal to integration of 0 to t v dt. And we also know that v is equal to v1 plus a t, where v1 is the initial velocity of the particle. Therefore, integration of r1 to r2 dr is equal to integration of 0 to t v1 plus a t dt. Now, integrating both sides, we have v2 r2 minus r1, r2, this is the displacement of the particle, r2 minus r1 is equal to v1 t plus half a t square. Or we can write r is equal to v1 t plus half a t square. This is the equation of the displacement of the particle moving with constant acceleration. We also know that v is equal to dr dt and a is equal to dv dt is equal to dv dr into dr dt. That's how you can write a is equal to v into dv dr. Therefore, we can write v vector dot dv vector is equal to a vector dot dr vector. Since the v vector and dv vector are in same direction and a vector and dr vector at the same direction, that's why we can write integration of v dv is equal to a dr. Here the lower limit of v is v1 and upper limit of v velocity is v2, and lower limit of vr is r1 and upper limit of r is r2. That is, v1 is the initial velocity of the particle and r1 is the initial position of the particle. V2 is the final velocity of the particle and r2 is the final velocity of that final position of the particle. This is the initial velocity and this is the final velocity, and this is the initial position and vector, and r2 is the final position vector of the particle. Now, integrating both sides, we have half v square, lower limit v1 to v2, upper limit v2, and a r2 minus r1. This gives v2 square is equal to v1 square plus 2ar, where r is the displacement of the particle, that is r2 minus r1. This is another equation of the motion of the particle with constant acceleration or uniform acceleration. Now, the displacement of the particle in nth second is equal to displacement of the particle during n second minus displacement of the particle during n minus 1 second. This is equal to integration of n1, integration of v with respect to t. The lower limit of the time t is n minus 1 and upper limit of the time t is n. This gives integration of v1 dt, lower limit n1 minus, so n minus 1 to n, and a constant, integration of t dt, the lower limit is n1 and upper limit is n t dt. This gives v1 t n1 n minus 1 to n half a into t square n minus 1 to n. This gives Rn vector is equal to V1 vector n minus whole into n minus 1 plus half a vector whole into n square minus n minus 1 whole square. This gives Rn is equal to V1 plus half a to n minus 1. This is the expression of displacement of the particle in nth second. So for today, I am going to close my discussion, and please subscribe my channel, and thank you for watching my video. Have a nice day.